Alright folks, welcome back to Let's Play Starcraft. I am the mysterious JG. It's time for the final mission of the Terran campaign. So let's do a quick review. We had our boot camp tutorial, then we did Wasteland and Backwater Station. Basically between the two of them, we are introduced to the idea that we are a magistrate working for the Confederate government, overseeing a small sort of backwater colony on the planet Marsara. But Marsara has been attacked by the Zerg, a strange race that seems to be an amalgam of different ideas from the Alien movie franchise. So we fight back, and even though the Confederate government tells us not to worry about it and that they'll take care of it, we see they're not moving fast enough, so at Jungle Jim Raynor's insistence, because he says, hey, trust me, we attack the Zerg, and we end up destroying a Confederate installation that's been infested by Zerg goop, and become enemies of the state. In desperate alliance, a revolutionary group called the Sons of Korhal helps us to escape from the planet. Even though I messed around a bit and fought off the Zerg, the plot idea is that it's an unstoppable Zerg attack, or that we've got really no way to save ourselves from the Zerg, so we just have to hold until someone can rescue us. And the Sons of Korhal do that. In return, before we leave, we help the Sons of Korhal raid the Jacobs installation to gather data on the Confederates, who we are now in more or less open revolt against. Our open revolt really begins when we go to Antigua Prime, and a female ghost named Sarah Kerrigan goes in and assassinates a Confederate officer who was the only thing apparently preventing the Antiguans from revolting against the Confederacy. And we work with the revolutionaries to destroy a Confederate base. Then the NORAD 2 ship goes down. The NORAD 2 ship is a Confederate, you know, warship, and there's a lot of confusion in the Confederacy because of this new open revolt, but the NORAD 2 goes down. We go to its rescue. We fight off a bunch of Zerg who are threatening the ship, and thereby recruit a Confederate general, Edmund Duke, one or the other, can never remember which, to our side. In the trump card mission, we find out that Arcturus Menx, the leader of the Sons of Korhal, or at least their spokesperson, he was introduced, but he appears to be the leader. He's gone through the information we got from the Jacobs installation, and he tells us that the Confederates apparently created the Zerg to use as a weapon against their enemies, but he's found out how they direct the Zerg using something called a psi emitter. Not a psi emitter. It's not like the host of Prairie Home Companion. It's not that guy going... No, it isn't the Prairie Home Companion guy. It's, in fact, this piece of technology that uses some kind of, like, psychological bullshit magic science power to lead the Zerg around. And they use this thing to direct the Zerg against their enemies. So we use it against them, and they are hoist upon their own petard. In the big push, General Duke leads an attack against orbital platforms to shake up the defenses around the Confederate capital world, Tarsonis, which we assume is heavily populated, but unbeknownst to Kerrigan or Raynor, this is actually part of a plan to get psi emitters in place to lead Zerg swarms. And the Zerg, it always seems weird to me that they can do this, but the Zerg can fly through space. They can fly through space, folks, the Zerg. They have to be able to, or like big chunks of the game don't work. But the Zerg fly through space and attack Tarsonis, the heavily populated Terran world, because Menx willed it to be so. Well, at this point, Raynor is pretty much willing, or is pretty much ready to just, like, have nothing more to do with Menx. But Kerrigan still feels loyalty to him, because apparently Kerrigan was trapped in a Confederate ghost program where they were, like, experimenting on her or whatever, and Menx is the one who got her out. So she has a lot of loyalty to him. And therefore, when the Protoss fleet comes, the Protoss I haven't even mentioned, they're this species of aliens who we really don't know anything about except that they keep appearing and, like, incinerating the worlds where the Zerg are. It's clear that they're trying to wipe out the Zerg. The Protoss come to Tarsonis, and their objective is to wipe out the planet, including the Terrans, something that Raynor doesn't really seem to pick up on. But Kerrigan realizes, as Menx orders her to engage the Protoss and stop them from interfering with the Zerg's slaughter of the Terrans on the planet, Kerrigan decides that she needs to fight the Protoss to stop them from burning the planet, and then she will convince Minsk to turn the Sons of Korhal's, you know, I don't know if she wants to do it with arms or use the Psi-emitter to lead them elsewhere, but she wants to try and find a way to get Minsk to, you know, grant Tarsonis a reprieve and let the innocent civilians survive. But in fact, as her forces eliminate the last of the Protoss, the Zerg, who she had been forbidden to engage, attack her group. They are instantly overrun, in desperate need of evacuation, or evac, as I started to say. And Manx instead orders his troops to withdraw. He does not want to take risks of losses in rescuing Kerrigan. He basically says that it's done. He has sent the Zerg to wipe out the Confederates on Tarsonis. That's what he wanted. The Protoss have been stopped. Kerrigan and her forces are expendable. And that's where we are now. Duke has just been a background character. The two main Terran personalities here, now that Kerrigan is dead, are Raynor and Minsk. Let's see whose side we, as the commander slash magistrate, will end up on in the final mission of the Terran campaign of Starcraft 1, the Hammer Falls. The Hammer Falls, command ship Hyperion, holding perimeter orbit over Confederate capital world Tarsonis.
The fleet has lost contact with the ground forces at New Gettysburg. General Minsk has ordered the immediate disengagement of the Korhal fleet from the Tarsonian system. Protoss and Zerg forces continue to battle across the...
So we didn't stop the Protoss.
Receiving incoming transmission.
Hey, man.
I can't believe he actually left her down there. I'm gone, and you better come with me. There's no telling who Arcturus will screw over next.
Good point.
Receiving incoming transmission.
Gentlemen, you've done very well.
I love
but
this.
But remember that we've still got a job to do. The seeds of a new empire have been sown. And if we hope to reach...
To hell with you!
You're making a terrible mistake.
Don't curse at me.
Think to cross me. I have sacrificed too much to let this fall apart.
You mean like you sacrificed Kerrigan?
You'll regret that. You don't seem to realize my situation here.
Is he mad?
I will not be stopped. Okay. Not by you, or the Confederates, or the Protoss, or anyone.
So does he feel bad about Kerrigan
I'll
or not?
I will rule this sector, or see it burnt to...
I will rule Sector 5!
The fleet is prepped and ready, Commander. Awaiting orders.
The hell with him. We're gone.
So we just let him rant away.
General Duke has successfully activated Tarsonis' primary defensive weapon, the Ion Cannon. The cannon must be shut down if any escape attempt is to be made.
Okay, well, I'm Jungle Jimmy, and I'm not actually going to say anything now. I'm just going to, you know, let this play out. Yeah, so he's activated the Statue of Liberty Cannon, which is like the ultimate weapon of the Neo-America colony, and it'll blow us up if we do anything, so let's blow it up first, which is doing something, so that means we'll be blown up, I don't know. I didn't mean to talk over Meg's big, like, rant they went into, but yeah, it seemed like, he said, like you sacrificed Kerrigan, you'll regret that. Just for a second, it seemed like he was upset at the idea that the death of Kerrigan didn't impact him. But then he starts going into full-on, you know, I will rule Sector 5 mode. And I think it's safe to say Minsk is now the villain.
Well, Commander, looks like we're on our own. It's funny. Seems like yesterday Arcturus was the idealistic rebel crusader.
Crap,
now he's the law and we're the criminals. Kills me to know that we helped him achieve his goals of conquest.
Anyways.
I shouldn't have let her go alone.
Yep. Should not have let her go alone. This is a nasty mission. This mission is nasty, brutish, but it's not short. It's going to take a while to get across there, because there is a hell of a lot between us and that.
Want to turn up the heat.
We do start out with some troops. But, frankly, we need to buckle down and defend ourselves for a while before we can do much of anything. So we need to get barracks built up there. We need to get them built fast. This is the first mission I was really worried about not being able to beat on the first try. Because I remember having, the first time through playing this game, I saved and loaded quite a bit playing this mission. I tried building barracks at the bottom of these ramps. That doesn't work. I did that because of the trouble I ran into when I tried to build at the top of the ramps, which was enemy siege tanks. Think well. This is a yeah. That's solid. We got to block this off, and we got to block this off, and then we got to be prepared for air attacks. Although now I don't remember what's going on over here. Can they get over here? They can use dropships and get over here and really make things irritating. So we've got to.
Affirmative.
Don't think they can really get over here. Oh, crap. Maybe they can get over here. I'm getting shot at by their dudes. Okay.
Reporting for duty.
Base is under attack.
Okay, apparently that is not a place where we can build. Yet. Oh, screw you guys. Alright, let's restart this thing.
Well, Commander, looks like we're on our own. It's funny.
Yeah, you keep talking, Jimmy.
The Arcturus was the idealistic rebel crusader. Now he's the law and we're the criminals. Kills me to know that we helped him achieve his goals of conquest. Damn it. I shouldn't have let her go alone.
Right away, sir.
Yeah, so I don't know what I can do to get rid of that guy quick. Other than send, like, a bunch of troops over there who will shoot him. But only after he starts shooting at them will they be able to shoot him. My attention, that is. You've got it.
Yes.
I just told you that.
Naturally.
Yes, sir?
So this should allow me to build barracks over here as soon as this... bunkers once the barracks are built. That's what I'm trying to say.
Job's finished. Can I read you? Right away, sir.
And he'll come down here just in case they start dropping guys. He'll be at least able to fight a little bit, I guess. Get the other vultures over there, too. Okay.
You got my attention.
Jacked up and good to go. Orders, Captain. SCV, good to go, sir. Yes, sir. Right away, sir.
Fired up.
I read you.
So I think we're going to get attacked from all sides quite soon, actually. I just remember this being a really nasty mission where your whole force can get wiped out any old time.
Outstanding.
Outstanding. I'm glad the job's finished.
Yes, sir.
Not enough minerals.
Job's finished.
Standing by.
Can I read you?
I'm going to keep him over here, actually, to repair. Because I have a feeling these guys are going to get attacked pretty soon. Now, this isn't... Yeah, this isn't too bad. They'd really have to... I don't think they're going to be able to drop too many guys right there, but... We need to get a factory going. We got so much stuff we got to do before we're really ready to defend ourselves. Because we got to get siege mode going. We're going to need to build an engineering base so that I can get missile launchers. Can't build them yet. And we'll need missile launchers because I believe they throw... I mean, this is the last Terran mission. I think the computer Terrans have everything at their disposal, up to possibly including nukes. I don't remember if they use nukes against you or not. But if they do... Yeah, as cool and fun as nukes are when you're using them, not a lot of fun to get hit with. Alright, well, wait a little bit on that. Okay, I've hotkeyed my SCVs. So that's good. Going on a factory to get some siege technology, siege tank technology. I have siege tanks. I have two of them, in fact. And I'll probably need to research spider mines in this one. I haven't been using them much, but... As a matter of fact, he's got three. Might not be a bad idea for Jungle Jim to use his spider mines. I tend to forget he's got them. He starts out with them. Normally you would need to research them. Destination. This is Jimmy. All right, come on, Jimmy. I'll get him out of your way. It's all good. Don't put it right there, Jimmy. Okay, put it right there after you kill these guys. Right on. Oh, yeah. Base is under attack. I think I got a damn cloaked wraith already. Did not take them long to start pissing me off, did it? Oh well, it's a one wraith is just going to be an annoyance. I know, I can hear it. I don't think I'll be using nukes, but I can't even build a commsat station without an academy. I've got all these tech buildings I don't start out with. Start out with more troops than I'm used to having at the beginning of one of these, but no tech buildings. Base is under attack. Yeah, I know it's under attack. Yeah, I know. It's under attack. Oh, well, actually, this should be of some help. This makes it, it's kind of tight. It'll be kind of difficult to move guys in and out of there without dropships, but The Wraith is stupid enough, it will keep shooting at this bunker as a missile turret is built. Finally. Oh, that was a ghost! It wasn't even a frickin'. But as you see, we blew up those guys. It was a ghost. So yeah, they definitely have cloaked ghosts. They're not using lockdown, thankfully. That would be very bad for us.
Research complete.
Excellent news. This is very good news. Now they will eventually attack us with siege tanks in siege mode. That's going to be very bad news. You can repair me so you don't fail the mission when I die. Be nice for lockdown to wear off. That'd be really nice, actually. Okay, well, I must have an academy, yeah. Also, I wouldn't have been able to build some of what I've been building. So let's get researching some of the stuff that we need.
Yes, sir?
Yes, sir,
yes, sir, yes, sir. Now, what's going to be annoying is that they are going to start sending siege tanks after us. So we need, as much as I usually avoid using them, I think we're going to need some wraiths, because those are the only things that are going to be able to zip beyond our lines quickly and easily to destroy their siege tanks. Because I've got them built tight enough that it's not going to be easy for infantry to move in and out just quickly. And we got a lot of minerals at the starting base, so we should be good for a while, but... I want to get an armory going fairly quickly, too. To improve those, siege tanks. Because we're going to be relying on them pretty heavily. I don't have enough Vespene gas. And now I do.
Upgrade complete.
Okay. What do wraiths cost? 150, 100. So I'll need plenty of both to really get them going. Trying to make sure that I've got enough people gathering all different kinds of resources. So far, the attacks have all been coming up here, but I have a feeling that this is going to be a hot spot too. I knew it as soon as I finished this. As soon as I queued up that Wraith, I knew, oh, you know what? I'm going to end up with my armory ready and not being able to afford any upgrades. But I really need to get those siege tanks upgraded, because if I can keep them alive, the siege tanks here are going to have a lot of kills before this is over. You've got zero. You've got zero, so maybe not. I don't know. And structures don't have a kill count, which annoys me, because structures that can kill people will sometimes end up killing a lot of people before mission's over. Yeah, I'm gonna... I'll upgrade the siege tanks first. I was thinking about upgrading the race because tank killers are going to be very important in this mission. If it plays like it has in my previous attempts, which has probably been years since I attempted this mission, but I remember Terran siege tanks showing up being frustrating. Maybe it only happened like one or two times, but it really stuck with me, folks. And I hate it when I lose track of an SCV like that. some spider mines going so I can get some use out of these non-Gym Ranger vultures that are hanging around. Well, there's only one. Need a science facility before I can upgrade that, so I'm not going to worry about it right this second. Although, you know what? I need to get those guys doing as much damage as I can quickly. It won't cost that much to build a science center without any attachment on it, and without... I won't start researching there for a while. And I think I need this... Yeah, I need a science facility to do armory level 2 upgrades also, so... Okay, I've officially got too many guys working on Vespine. My rates can't even cloak right now, but... Okay. You get over there. No, these guys are in the way. Alright. Oh, he's still in the way, so...
What are you on?
I hope they don't attack while I'm playing around with moving my stuff. Computer is certainly not averse to doing that. Can you just not get over there at all, no matter what, because of where I put the missile turret? Oh, fuck, you can't move because of the missile turret. Alright. Well, I'll get a dropship eventually, but... Jeez. Alright, let's work on getting a dropship. Meanwhile, these spider mines are still in place, so that's good. That one blew up because somebody came by. And needed to be killed. Alright, he can't get to that thing. Although I think if this guy moved, he could. Oh, you son of a bitch. Alright, well, nothing can save this SCV, so fuck. He's gonna die. That's one of the most irritating little things that they can do to you, is to, use science vessel stuff on your SCVs. That's really irritating. Anyway, I've now hotkeyed him, so that, as irritating as it was, it only cost us 50 minerals. And it would probably be a wise idea to invest in more, well, we'll get a dropship going for one thing. I was going to say more siege tanks. Can we afford more siege tanks? Yes, we can. And looks like Vespine's going to be a pretty big limiting factor for us for a while. So, Marine Rush might actually be a good idea. I have to build up some more facilities for that. Now, I should not go shooting off my mouth, but so far this hasn't been as bad as I was afraid of. It could turn ugly at any point if I just suddenly get attacked by a bigger force than I can handle, but... Because if either of these two lines cracks, I'm pretty much done. Because I don't have a big standing army at the base to deal with situations.
Complete. Nuclear launch detected.
Son of a bitch! I needed to get science vessels going faster. Get out of there, guys. This is all going to get blown up, folks. Couldn't save them. And they are almost certainly going to come through that way now. Alright, so I need science vessels. I finally got this thing going. That would have helped, too. Shit. What did I say, folks? They're a lot of fun, not when they're being used against you.
Orders, Captain. Orders received.
I need to replace those Marines, too.
Orders, sir.
At least I knew it would be one of those two spots, so at least I got the damn, siege tanks out of there before they got wiped out. So I'm going to have to use the comsat to find those guys, unless I want to build two science vessels to patrol. And if I do build science vessels, Ghost will keep casting lockdown on them, which can be annoying. Standing by, boy.
Outstanding. Orders, sir. Identify target.
Orders, Captain.
Identify target, Captain.
You want a piece of me, boy.
Affirmative.
Identify target.
Oh, never mind. He doesn't actually need a... Oh, the vulture couldn't get through because of its size.
We're in for some chop.
Orders, Captain.
Alright.
Right away, sir.
The bulky vulture can't get through. Lost track of which one was actually hotkeyed up there, so. Okay, so the old me would have loaded, but the new me is going to not panic and try to recover. With these siege tanks, I can use them to kill the ghosts, but only if the ghosts I can see them before the nuclear launch has been, you know, incoming so long. They hit a point where they no longer need the ghost to guide it anymore. And if you hit that point, you're screwed. Yeah, I'm going. I'm going. Leave me alone. This ghost is now pretty much worthless. Or this vulture. Vultures I don't care about. Once he's laid his spider mines, he ceases to be useful. I know it's heartless. Heartless. But hey, that's how I feel. So I'm continuing to build my army of wraiths because the day is coming when I'm going to need them against siege tanks. Meantime, I might build another vulture just to drop more spider mines and then let it die. So I'm going to take a risk here. I'll go ahead and save the game. I thought about building science vessels. I figure instead I will use this, but you've got to be kind of fast. Yeah, you can. Okay, you can hotkey those. I didn't know you could do that. So I can...
Alright, bring it on. Alright, bring it on. Woo!
I copied that thing about the Wraith awaiting launch orders.
I'm listening. Hang on, we're in for some chops.
What do you want?
Yeah, I'm going.
Hopefully I won't run into troops.
I dig.
I ran into troops.
Oh, is that it?
Ah, crap, I'm not even gonna get to lay my damn spider mines. Ultimate nightmare. Wasted a vulture who couldn't even lay out his spider mines.
Yeah,
Alrighty. So I'm not so much worried about infantry armor because I'm not ready to. I wasn't going to attack yet, although I need to think about being more aggressive on this level than I sometimes have been in the past. Taking out one of their bases before I've had my resources sucked dry. And the best way to do that is with massed marines. That's just the strategy that's worked best for me. Works well for a couple of reasons, not the least of which is the fact that when you mass marines, it's only costing you minerals, not Bespin. And Bespin can take a long time to accumulate in this game, because you can only have four guys accumulating it for you at once. I don't think I'll bother with anything as high-tech as that right now. I need the tech for other things. I might want to go ahead and build another armory so that I can research Wraith advances and Siege Tank advances at the same time. And eventually, you know what? I'll build a physics lab, because at the end of this whole thing, if memory serves, there is a section of their base of the ion cannon. There's like empty space between you and it where you have to use flyers to get across. Aerial units. You can use dropships, but you've got to have something to punch your way past the air defenses on their outer perimeter. So this is a mission that really encourages you to use battle cruisers anyway. Set rally points. Let's get 4 fire bats and 8 marines per group. I'll research extra energy for my battle cruisers, even if I won't have any for a while. Somebody just got shot by a siege cannon. Do not want to waste a commsat energy, because I do not want to be in a situation where I don't have enough energy when I hear that nuclear launch detected. Shit, I need additional supply depots. They're required, folks. Yes, spawn more supply depots! Yeah, you've only got so much space to build it over here, too. So I'm gonna try to improve those wraiths. Arguably, I should be improving the siege tanks and using siege tanks backed by marines to attack. I might end up doing that eventually. Yeah, because if I encounter siege tanks parked in their base, my marines will get chewed up. I will probably, if you guys don't mind, and even if you do, save before my first big attempt to launch an offensive foray. Go on, Stimpaks. My Vulture only got to lay out one mine. I'm not sure. These guys must be coming over this way, then, or come over here somewhere. Running low on minerals and gas again. Got your message about that upgrade. Don't know how it really affects me, but naturally. Oh, that upgrade. Yeah, I'm not even sure why I spent money on that at this point. Guess I want my battle cruisers to be as good as possible. And you know what? Yeah, I should be researching stuff for my wraiths because it will help my battle cruisers later. Whereas since I'm not planning on doing anything with Goliaths or vultures, the only units that are benefiting from the ground technology research are the siege tanks. So the siege tanks are important. I upgraded their attack, but I'm not that worried about upgrading their defense, because they're going to be behind the bunkers for right now.
Go ahead, HQ.
Maybe I've been over worried about this. Alright, there's like one guy over there.
Orders, Captain?
Need a light?
You want a piece of me, boy? You want a piece of me, boy?
Don't know how many of these guys I want to have built before I attack, but I'm afraid to go around scanning too much with this. Oh, I probably just need to build some damn science vessels and be done with it. One for each major entrance. That's a lot of Espion, though.
Upgrade complete. Research complete. Upgrade complete.
Want to turn up the heat? Yes. You got it.
Okay. Trying to remember how I have people hotkeyed. One more group of,
upgrade complete.
Can't really afford to build the fire bat portion of this next group, but maybe I'll have one group that's all Marines. But even then, 250, yeah, I can't really afford to build 12 more Marines right now. But I still stand by my belief that it's a good idea to keep these guys over here. Because ghosts will lock those things down. And then enemy Marines will attack them while they're like sticking out in front. And it annoys me. Oh boy, there's a big group of them coming. Good thing I can see them. Yeah, it's a really good thing I have my science vessel there, because otherwise those siege tanks would have been firing at me where I couldn't see them. Oh, that went beautifully. That was a big attack wave, too. It's not over yet, but man, I'm saving after that. That was beautiful. Barely even touched me. That was awesome. I'm under attack from over here. Now, there's red and white. I think one of these is the Confederates, and the other one is the Sons of Korhal. I'm not sure which is which. In other missions, red has typically... Well, I should say in Brood War and Starcraft 2 missions, when Minx is, like, openly your enemy, typically red is the color of the Minx forces. Okay. Pretty pleased with how that came out. Now I did order them to build a new supply depot, but they got stopped.
Input coordinates. Strap yourselves in, boys.
Reporting for duty.
I'm a little less... more supply depots are required. I'm not as worried about keeping my comsat station totally powered up. Yeah, so far we haven't found their base. There's their base. Well, that's a building anyway. Doesn't look like they've got choke points guarded by siege tanks in siege mode, but they certainly have a lot of units. And siege tanks don't necessarily need to be in siege modes to kill Marines pretty quickly.
Greetings, Command.
Okay. you know, some ghosts with nukes wouldn't necessarily be a miss here, but I think it's advised that you take out this red base. There's a white base over here that you can kind of bypass. I think that represents the Confederates. Minx guys, it makes sense to me that they really want to kill you. Not even sure why the Confederates care. They probably don't know the difference between you and Manx. They're certainly not interested in hearing about how you don't approve of what we've had to do. Oh, you know, this whole thing with the using the Zerg against you, we feel really bad about that. Don't kill us. Yeah, that's not going to happen. They're a little more pissed at you than is going to be forgiven. This research here rolling.
Upgrade
complete. Then I'm gonna save and see how much damage we can do to the red base. Oh, we got a problem. How the hell do I get out of here? I got too much shit in the way. Don't want to build a whole army of dropships either. I guess it'll just be a few guys at a time then. I did just save if I find a bunch of hostiles right here.
You got my attention.
Maybe you guys could get through because you're small.
Input coordinates. Hang on, we're in for some chop.
I read you.
Roger that. Destination? Hang on, we're in for some chops.
You got my attention.
Input coordinates.
Okay, keep this up. Well, these little, like, arboretums that they've got up here that have all, I guess, been destroyed, or this. It's a war zone, but there's still room for gardening. Get you up here so you don't get left behind.
Destination. Strap yourselves in, boys.
Without siege tanks backing them up, this might be a really bad idea. The Vespian geyser's depleted. This is bad news. This is an indication that we need to advance and take over another base.
I'm listening. I copy that.
Yes.
Cool. I managed to keep the hotkeyed units intact. All right. So let's head on over. Oh, there's an attack going on, even. Oh, wow, that thing's still gonna get destroyed. So it's kind of a shame that they attacked while I was trying to defend, or they attacked while I was getting ready to attack, because it's making it really hard to manage everything at once, but I don't know how many, they've slipped out of siege mode. This will make them easier to kill, hopefully. They should be coming around this corner over here now. Yeah. Get in close and then attack it. Ah, crap. Yeah, they're gonna die. So how much damage did they do? Did they do enough? I don't really think so. This tank got out of that with one hit point left. That's pretty awesome.
Receiving headquarters.
Upgrade complete.
So maybe I should have used... all that's left to research is vehicle plating, so it no longer makes sense to have two of these. Oh, and I didn't research armor. No wonder they died so fast. Oh, come on, JG. Get with it. I should have a good few minerals left. I'm just on trace Vespine. That had to have put a hurtin' into their capacity to attack me, right? How big is this freaking base supposed to be? It continues up there. Nope. That's it. I think, probably. If I'd managed that better, I would have wiped them out. At any rate, I'll have another chance. And there's a big old base up here that's generally recommended you just leave alone. Although I've played this before and wiped out every single unit on the map and left the ion cannon for last. Yeah, and the my big fear was lots of siege tanks in siege mode, but in fact, with the science vessel positioned up here, I guess I just, last time I played this, I probably just wasn't as good at Starcraft. I was running into big problems with siege tanks because they were attacking from over here, and I couldn't see them because all I had was the detector missile turret. I guess I just didn't realize that I should have been using a science vessel. But at this point, did we take out their factory? If we took out their factory, well, they've still got guys. They might be rebuilding. A computer will do that in a random map. Sometimes in the campaign mode, they won't rebuild. But if they don't have a factory anymore, then we might be done with the red siege tanks. And this other army, they attacked us with a nuke pretty early and frustrated me, but they haven't been back since. Which may mean that they're building up for the biggest mother of all attacks kind of attack. There they are. They've got a lot of stuff parked waiting for us to attack them.
You want a piece of meat, boy?
You want a pizza meat, boy?
You want a piece of meat, boy?
You give me my cheese whiz, boy.
Piece of meat, boy? Can I read you?
Let's get you to safety, little buddy. Let's not get you running around over there. Let's get you to safety.
Hang on, we're in for some chop.
More Marines! That's the key. We didn't build enough Marines.
Give me something to shoot. Let's move. Jacked up and good to go. You want a piece of me, boy? You want a piece of me, boy?
I gotta remember to save something. At some point, I'm gonna have to build, battlecruisers. The battlecruisers will then get attacked by wraiths from this base, and possibly battlecruisers from that base. If I leave that base alive, it will try to stop me from destroying the ion cannon, but that's just something we'll have to live with.
Upgrade complete. Upgrade complete.
So we're going to end up upgrading everything. which leads me to believe I'm taking too long. Although this is a tough mission, I feel like I'm doing okay. Reporting in.
Jacked up and good to go. Give me something to shoot. Let's move.
Job finished. Orders, Captain.
You get out of there? Good, you can.
I read you.
Jacked up and good to go. Outstanding.
This would be a really good place to have a Nidus Canal for a... That is a Zerg structure that allows you to get guys in and out of your base. Not a Terran structure, but boy, it would be fun if the Terrans had Nidus Canals right now. Generally, their hotkey groupings will be retained if I do not attempt to use hotkeys while they are going back and forth between being in dropships. My real problem with StarCraft is that I'm just not fast enough. I mean, you know, people who play the game really well and play against other humans just do it much faster than I do. I think I've got the general idea of the game down, which is attack only when you have overwhelming force. Otherwise, the resources you spent on your attackers are wasted if you don't break the enemy. Okay, where's this nuclear launch at? Nuclear launches... I don't see the nuclear launch. Did we prevent it? No, he's up here. Ah, crap. How did it... Where was he? Alright, I don't understand what happened there, but I'm not happy about it. Obviously, this is going to change our plans a little bit. We're going to have to... Well, these survived. I really only lost 2 siege tanks and all that. The bunkers survive, but need to be repaired immediately. I'm not sure exactly where that ghost was that he wasn't detected by the science vessel. I probably should have had the science vessel patrolling. I also lost the science vessel now that I think about it. That was that bloop, 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 bloop sound was him blowing up. I don't think he came this way. He must have come up here. Oh man, if only you guys had... He would have been so killed if he'd been detected. But of course that's been the case for... Wow, with all those siege tanks there.
Outstanding.
No, get on there, yeah.
I read you.
Ready to roll out.
So, they got me. Again. I got nuked again. Because I just don't have good defenses against nukes. There will be a mission in Brood War where you get to choose... You're gonna in a mission. You have to eliminate either their nuclear capacity or their capacity to build battle cruisers in the next mission. The map is identical, so I'm probably not gonna bother to do it twice to show you both versions. But I will probably have more trouble with nukes than battle cruisers. Explorer reporting, and hopefully not about to get killed. Oh, man. Yeah. I'm hurting for gas. That's true. Okay, so I'm going to fly up here.
Orders received.
Your forces are under attack.
Roger that.
Who's attacking him? Get out of there, then. Jeez. God, I'm glad he's not completely wiped out. That would have just been a huge waste of Vespian. Oh, I almost wiped out my freaking siege tank, though. Frustrating. Did I accidentally build two more of you guys? Well, maybe I meant to build two more of you.
Destination?
Commander.
Oh, wow. So they're building battlecruisers, eh? Well, I knew it was coming. And battlecruisers against masses of Marines is actually not a good combination for them.
Input coordinates.
So I lost a couple of guys there. That noise made me panic for a second until I realized it was my guys getting out of a dropship. I was like, oh no, they've dropped behind my base!
Receiving headquarters.
Not hindquarters, headquarters.
Excellent.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Orders received. Affirmative.
You patrol here so that we can hopefully find any frickin' ghosts. Unless he couldn't have nuked us from over here. If he didn't come through here, he had to have come up here. And that won't happen again. Now I got the mother load of Marines up here, but...
Jacked up and good to go. Let's move. Outstanding. Rock and roll, Commander. Outstanding.
Do I have a bunch of Marines sitting around not attacking? No, good. Unless you count these guys. Crap. Oh well, they'll be the next group. Because I'm already anticipating that I'll need more. Go ahead and break them. We'll make more.
Your forces are under attack.
Yeah, we need to get rid of this. They built another factory. We need to destroy it. For sure. And we need to wipe out their command centers. Until they start attacking somebody again, I'm just going to manually order everybody to attack the damn command center. Except for a couple guys to attack the SCVs. Okay, this should be it for them. Oh, actually, you stay here in case. But here they are producing individual soldiers, one at a time, so we've wiped these guys out. Very good. Want a pizza meat boy? See, I never heard it before. That guy freaking... Ugh. Yeah, you're right. Now I can't unhear it. Okay, let's get rid of these things just in case. They've got resources left and are going to start building battle cruisers. That appears to have been what the other Terran civilization was doing. We're just not taking advantage of all of your firepower like this. Okay, there we go. What upgrade? Oh good, I've got all upgrades except for the infantry armor. So I got all the upgrades for siege tanks and for wraiths and stuff before getting all the upgrades for infantry, which is the unit I'm actually using. Way to go, GG. And there's dropships, probably empty. I don't really need to worry too much about all these buildings, but definitely I need to get rid of missile turrets, because even after all of their units are destroyed, their missile turrets will continue to harass my ships as they fly around. Do they even have Vespian Geyser? They do have a Vespian Geyser. Why did you guys attack over here? I didn't see that.
Yes, sir!
They destroyed my missile turret at some point.
Reporting for duty.
What is that sound? Guys, do I need to do everything?
Reporting for duty.
I keep hearing this. Well, that must be buildings exploding up the red base or something.
Destination orders served.
Input coordinates.
Well, you can build a replacement missile turret, but I was really gonna send him over there to try to get a new base started. Because we're going to need Vespine. We really don't have enough air power to actually get to the ion cannon. Wiping out this red base will definitely make our lives a lot easier. Jungle Jimmy has 6 killers. Nice, Jungle Jimmy. Some of you may be wondering why I call him Jungle Jim Raynor. It is purely because it's kind of vaguely alliterative. It reminds me of that guy Jungle Jim Stu. You remember that guy Jungle Jim Stu? Yeah. Oh, and there's, of course, somehow you guys missed this. I was about to send my wraiths to attack. Oh, there's one little red thing. I'm not sure what it is. I'll send the wraiths to attack it. Yeah. That would have been stupid. The wraiths would have gotten, you know, not wiped out or anything, but damaged. All right, it's typical. Like I said, usually red represents Manxx's forces. So as much fun as it is to think that Arcturus Manxx has been completely wiped out here, he obviously hasn't. But these were the Manx ground forces that were going to try to prevent us from escaping. And they're gone. Now it's just the white force, which I'm pretending is the Confederates, although who knows where they're supposed to be.
Roger. Commander, let's move.
Very good, and I'm almost positive there's nothing down here. So we've cleared one of the two threats. Alright, I only had to restart once, and it was like 2 minutes in when I realized, ah, screw it, this didn't go the way I wanted. It's early, I'm quitting.
Go, 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 Commander. Rock and roll. Go, go, go.
Standing by. Coordinates received.
Reporting for duty. Can I read you? Right away, sir.
Now you get over here and build a command center. And I think the best thing I can do is find out exactly where that enemy base is and just build defenses right outside of it so that their crossing over points are blocked. You, meanwhile, got attacked again while I wasn't paying attention. Yep, they got attacked again while I was over there doing other stuff. At least it wasn't a nuclear launch this time. That would appear to be one entrance. That would appear to be another entrance. They do mostly use flyers, though, I think. Yeah, if I could, like, bunker off all of that. I think that's what I need to do. If I can just, like, get ground defenses here, I got them.
Upgrade complete.
Reporting for duty.
Give me some issue. Rock and roll. Go, go, go. Reporting it.
This place here, probably never going to get attacked again, but...
Input coordinates.
Meantime, I'm afraid to send a lot of guys over there before I know that this is going to work.
Outstanding.
I don't really want to attack, I just want to... kind of cut them off. But they were dragged into an attack. They're gonna freaking irradiate one Marine. They're gonna irradiate more than one Marine. I gotta get rid of this irradiated Marine, because he's gonna kill everybody else. This sucks. I didn't mean to get a pitched battle going here. I don't have enough energy. Oh, shoot! The ghosts are gonna kill my guys until I can get enough energy. Then the ghosts will get killed pretty quickly, actually.
Your forces are under attack.
Receiving headquarters. Excellent.
Yeah, guys, it's gonna keep shooting at these guys. He's a jerk.
Commander, let's move.
Your forces are under attack.
They're jerks. I don't like them. Yeah. Alright, this place is,
Your forces are under attack.
We have you on visual.
Yeah, so you just need to be able to see them.
Commencing.
Go ahead, HQ. Strap yourself in, boy.
Standing by. Let's move.
Screw it, man. Low-tech victory. Let's take out that base if they're going to be jerks and send a bunch of ghosts after us. That'll mean that we'll have all the time in the world to finish off the ion cannon. There's nothing over there but stationary anti-air defenses. It might be boring for you guys to watch, but, what else is new? Affirmative. I do want a piece of you, sir, boy. I mean, sir. Alright, boy. Want a piece of you, sir.
I copy that.
You want a piece of me, boy. You want a piece of me, boy. You want a piece of me, boy.
You know, might as well just start building as many of these as I can. Which ain't that, not that many, actually. It's one. But at least he'll have a Yamato cannon saved up when I'm finally ready to use him.
Give me something to shoot. Standing by. You want a piece of me, boy? You want a piece of me, boy?
They don't really seem to have a lot of siege tanks over there.
We're in for some chop.
They got barracks, but it seems like they were mostly building,
Orders received.
Ghosts. Maybe I'm overestimating my chances. They've got a lot of Goliaths.
Not enough energy.
You want a piece of me, boy? You want a piece of me, boy? Jacked up and good to go. Outstanding. Standing by. Go, go, go!
Greetings,
you want a piece of me, boy? You want a piece of me, boy?
Excellent.
You want a piece of me, boy?
So there's areas in the middle that you can mine and whatever. He's under attack. This sucks. Basically, I wanted him up here so that he could spot, ghosts and stuff.
Go ahead, Commander.
That guy keeps chasing him. He's gonna get killed.
Vector locked in.
Although they used their scanny thingy to see us, but. They do have siege tanks at work. Alright. Let's attack. They got their siege tanks going. Kill it at least. Jeez. Ah, crap, that was a total waste. Oh, I had a bunch of guys didn't attack! You gotta finish off at least that damn siege tank. barely survived, and it'll get repaired. Damn it! Alright, well, I got another whole force of guys ready to go, but this is not really the most efficient way to do this. I think maybe it's time for... I'd say it was time for battlecruisers versus battlecruisers, but honestly... I need to wrap this thing up. I'm gonna get you over here so that place isn't totally undefended. You could use some repairs from somebody. I'm just worried that they'll eventually find that little tiny expansion I started over here, which is just a command center. And, it'll get destroyed, because it has no defenses whatsoever. But, the effort involved in building real defenses for it just seems like too much right now. You know, I could use one or two battlecruisers to take those out, and then just bring in lots of dropships. That'll save me going across that bridge, but... yeah, whatever.
Receiving transmission.
The other thing I could do is start working on trying to actually win the mission by getting up to the ion cannon. Ion cannon's got a mix of guys from both groups. Interesting.
Hailing frequencies open. In the cage.
These take a while to build, so might as well get started. Okay, so yeah, I need, I'm gonna have a couple of battle cruisers to get us across the gap there. I lost all my frickin' wraiths in a foolhardy attempt to just mess with this base, which I could take this base. It's not very big in space, but space is the police. They've got lots of ghosts who will lock down my battle cruisers if my battle cruisers try to attack, and they've got a lot of Goliaths who will then kill my battlecruisers. Somebody from their side is coming over here. Oh, they're sending over ghosts to lock this thing down if it tries that again. Jeez.
In the cage. You want a piece of me, boy? You want a piece of me, boy? You want a piece of me, boy?
I'm saving, but that base is going to bother me. I need to get rid of it.
You want a piece of me, boy? You want a piece of me, boy?
Yes, sir!
You want a piece of me, boy?
Identify target! Proceeding!
You want a piece of me, boy? You want a piece of me, boy?
Absolutely!
Okay, hold on, siege tanks. We'll use this transport to get you guys out. Foot soldiers can move out on their own. Not to mention, with those guys gone, you guys can get to work on mining. I mean, they still can attack. That's why I saved. I'm kind of taking a big risk, but I just really don't feel like doing this anymore, so I need to start killing them big time. I'll really need at least one more science vessel in case they lock that down and destroy it, but I've got that thing queued up building battlecruisers now, so... And until those guys get up there, I'm not going to have enough minerals to build much of anything. Now, these guys really won't be all that terribly useful at the end game against the cannon. I'm going to have to use air to do that, or break a little hole in it. I can get dropships in and take it out, actually. That's probably really the smartest thing to do. But with all those ghosts there and their lockdown ability, they'll lock down my dropships and then shoot them out of the sky, so...
Base is under attack.
This is just typical. Oh, Jungle Jimmy can take care of him. All right, so maybe I need to keep just a couple of guys over here. Damn. Suddenly they're going vulture crazy. Oh, the ladies go vulture crazy, but now the white Terran team has. Which I guess means Caucasian Terran team.
Go ahead, HQ.
Orders, sir!
Some issue.
Oh, at least they managed to find these guys without wiping out my new best buddies over there. Yeah, I think they're kind of broken, too. I mean, that was a weird attack. I think they're just not building new stuff so much as throwing old stuff at me. Stuff that's been sitting around in their base not doing anything.
Your forces are under attack.
Yes, sir!
Battle cruiser operational.
Receiving transmission.
Your forces are under attack.
Yeah, this is just weird. Okay.
Orders, sir. Delighted to, sir. Orders, sir. Absolutely.
And I don't feel that much need to try to salvage these guys when, I don't have medics because it's not Brood War. Yeah, they're using dropships, okay. Oh, there's another whole group of them moving in. What? Where? Where's their nuclear launch? Make sure Raynor's not there. Get out of there, Raynor. That would be a bad way to lose a level at this point. You can launch a nuke at these guys, whatever. This is getting silly. I need to wipe them out. Oh, this is so frustrating to me right now. This is the thing about StarCraft, is the computer can do 8 things at once, and I'm like, okay, you got a nuclear launch right in the middle of like 2 other battles? Bah.
All crews reporting.
set a course.
Your forces are under attack.
And they just locked one of these guys down. That's great. They took away all my energy with their science vessel. Whatever.
Your forces are under attack.
Good day, Commander.
This thing's not even upgraded.
Frequencies open. Receiving transmission. Take it slow.
Transmit orders.
Did they shoot down my dropship? Was that their dropship? There was a dropship, but theirs shot down. I'm trying to decide if I lost a dropship and all that.
Because
I need to think about just, I need to think about ending this thing, damn it. There they are going again. Now there's like freaking fire bats, but I don't have anybody in these bunkers anymore because I got tired of holding those bunkers.
Frequencies open. All crews reporting. Take it slow.
Yeah, they're just massing lots of fire bats here. It's getting strange. They must be out of minerals. They're using a lot of ghosts. Well, no, fire bats cost a lot of... I was going to say they must be out of minerals, but fire bats cost the same amount of minerals as marines. Point is, I keep trying to get an attack organized, but they're gonna shoot down a freaking battle cruiser here. I hate ghosts.
Receiving transmission. Good day.
And they locked it down too.
Base is under attack. Your forces are under attack.
Yes, sir. Orders received.
Transmit orders.
Commander. Rock
and roll. I got enough minerals for more stuff now, but I get so disorganized. All right.
Your forces are under attack.
Reporting for duty.
I hate ghosts. I hate their lockdown skill. Okay. Okay, you guys don't have siege tanks in place? Oh, you do have siege tanks in place.
Yes, sir! Absolutely!
Your forces are under attack.
Identify target! Yes, sir! Identify target!
Can you shoot him? Please shoot him! Shoot him! Can you not shoot him?
Destination.
Maybe that's why he can't shoot you.
Absolutely.
Shoot him. Shoot him. Out of range. Just shoot it.
Greetings, Command.
Kill, 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 kill. Freaking Confederates. It's not our fault that we did bad stuff to you. Manx tricked us somehow. I don't think I'll even bother with siege mode. I'm just going to, like, attack.
Go ahead, HQ. In transit, HQ.
Now, I guess you guys are both ready to head up here and join them for the eventual assault, and you can repair the one that's in the most need of repair.
Your forces are under attack.
We need to wipe out the command centers, but we also need to wipe out whatever they're using to build, whatever they still got that can build units. Maybe they don't have anything left. Well, they can still build these guys.
Your forces are under attack.
That wore off. We get that going again.
Not enough energy.
There must be a siege tank back here or something. Or a ghost, or I don't know.
Receiving headquarters. Let's roll.
All crews reporting.
Alright, so that's the other base gone. Boy, this took a while, but... And as I was hoping to avoid doing it this way, but they were just gonna keep bothering me. Too bad we don't have a Zerg Queen. We can infest those command centers. Be a very different campaign if we had a Zerg Queen on our side. We would pretty much be flat out the bad guys if we were using Zerg Queens here. Okay, once again, scan up there and get rid of these wraiths. Oh, they had a bunch of wraiths, or Goliaths over here on this platform. They don't have anything, I don't think they have anything to build units up there. But they had just some stuff for stuff. What am I saying? I don't know. Just in case, time to get multiple starports going. Should have enough air power to do it without multiple starports, but this will ensure that we can crank out units to finish this off.
Good day, Commander.
Reporting for duty. We have you on visual.
No nukes were used. Maybe I should have figured out a way to use nukes. Go ahead and finish off their last couple supply depots. I don't think there's any more units over here. And I think whoever's still up here has given up on fighting for any of this, because there's nothing left worth saving.
complete.
Yeah, they they took away all the units that were protecting this place. So it's freaking over at this point. Okay. There really shouldn't be anything left to do. Let's just come up here and take it slow. Like the man said. We're just going to fly up here and try to find the path of least resistance. Then I think if we have all five of them, Yamato gun this target. They can probably eat some hits from this missile turret. Or I can do the smart thing and take out that missile turret. I feel a little bad about the fact that we'll apparently be letting them... Well, maybe I need to take out these missile turrets, because at this point, they're all that's left on the map, probably, for the computer. Well, no, there's this.
Good day, Commander. Your forces are under attack.
All crews reporting.
They just took away our energy, didn't they? Bastards, the science vessels, I don't use it often, but it has a move that takes away your energy. So that you can't use, like, for example, Yamato cannon. And that's what they've done.
Set the course.
And now I thought that this was Menk's guys and the Confederates, but it can't be because they're all hanging out together in, like, perfect harmony up here. But at any rate, yeah, we've hit the point where... They don't have any mobile units left. They threw away their mobile units trying to defend that base. Now, finally kill this fucker.
Die. Die. Die.
And the dropships who were, like, harassing me forever.
Yes, you deserve death.
So you're really supposed to just get a powerful enough force of these things going that they can fly through, take hits from enemy attackers and stationary defenders, and still be too strong to be stopped and take out the ion cannon. Instead, I've just decided to, like, clear the entire enemy base again. That's just the way that we've always played. Me, Bobo, and Lagman, we just... it's a habit I can't seem to break, even for the LP where I'm trying to. It's like, no, I always fall into this pattern where I just, like, decide to take the base. Because I just hate being harassed when I'm in the middle of trying to attack. At this point, it would be silly not to finish them all off when there was only, like, you know, 10 to 12 missile turrets were all that's left of the Terrans, who are not me. So I want to make sure that I didn't miss anything. No, some Vespine here, but that should be it. That should mean that the entire enemy military has been defeated. All their units, all their buildings are belong to us, as far as I can make out. And the battle cruiser is operational. What more could you need? Let's finish the Terran campaign with one more cry of... Battle cruiser operational? I had three of them cranking out at the same time. Oh well. Not enough energy, probably, but... Yep. Damn science vessel, its EMP shockwave prevented us from seeing five different Yamato cannons going at once. That would have been awesome. Awesome way to end it. Instead, not with a bang, but with a whimper, ends the Terran campaign. Congratulations!
We have been victorious! Yeah, whatever.
Whew, so let's see. Killed 247 units, lost 175. So I lost more units than either of the computer opponents. I had the highest losses of anybody. 90 minutes of pure, unadulterated death. But I don't consider that first time I restarted to really count, because it's just like I lost one SCV and I was like, screw it, I'm starting over, because I didn't realize somebody was right there. I don't think that counts. This is first try. I'm pretty happy. Apparently we missed structures of theirs, though. I don't see how, but whatever. Total spent. I see, that's the thing. How many guys at the elite? Yeah, because it is both Sons of Korhal. Ah, these are Minsk's boys, and these are Duke's boys. But at any rate, I mean, they only spent 2345. I don't understand the total spent, because it's like somehow it's a combination of gas and minerals, but they only spent that much. I mean, they threw a lot of stuff at us. The answer is that they started with a huge standing army. Well, not huge, but they had a pretty big standing army at the beginning of this map. Oh, it took us 90 minutes to do it, about the length of a feature film, folks, but it's a feature film in which the Terran campaign came to an end. The Terrans, in the only question in my mind, whenever someone asks me, JG, what's your favorite ending cinematic of a StarCraft campaign? The only question I have to ask them is, well, does Brood War count? And if it does, then the only question in my mind is it the Terran campaign from StarCraft or the Terran campaign from Brood War? Because the Terran endings are always, always the best. Let's watch the ending of the Terran campaign. Coronation of Arcturus I, Emperor of the Terran Dominion Throne World Korhal. Even StarCraft II's Wings of Liberty's ending isn't as good as the Terran endings from StarCraft I.
Fellow Terrans, I come to you in the wake of recent events to issue a call to reason. Let no human deny the perils of our time. While we battle one another, divided by the petty strife of our common history, the tide of a greater conflict is turning against us.
It's just little things that we're angry about.
Destroy all that we have accomplished. It is time for us as nations and as individuals to set aside our long-standing feuds and unite. The tides of an unwinnable war are upon us, and we must seek refuge on higher ground lest we be swept away by the flood. The Confederacy is no more. Whatever semblance of unity and protection it once provided is a phantom, a memory. With our enemies left
unprotected,
who will you turn to for protection? The devastation wrought by the alien invaders is self-evident. We have seen our homes and communities destroyed by the calculated blows of the Protoss. We have seen firsthand our friends and loved ones consumed by the nightmare surge. Unprecedented and unimaginable though they may be, these are the signs of our time. The time has come, my fellow Terrans, to rally to a new banner. In unity lies strength. Already many of the dissident factions have joined us. Out of the many, we shall forge an indivisible whole, capitulating only to a single throne. And from that throne, I shall watch over you. From this day forward, let no human make war upon any other human. Let no Terran agency conspire against this new beginning. And let no man consort with alien powers. And to all the enemies of humanity, seek not to bar our way. For we shall win through, no matter the cost.
I mean, it's inspiring. You'd be totally behind it. With the Zerg and the Protoss attacking humanity, everything he says makes sense. But this is the guy who unleashed the Zerg on what seems to be the most populated Terran world in the sector so that he could take power. It's just awesome. My only complaint about the whole thing is that for some reason they have his voice volume down below some of the background sound effect volume. I mean, it's a really good speech. I don't know who the voice actor is that did Minx, but I really love the voice for that character. It's just awesome. It's awesome. The Terran campaign is complete, folks. The Zerg campaign can at last begin. I might personally take a little break of recording so that I can catch up on Starflight 2, Trade Routes of the Cloud Nebula. I can never get through these names. But for anybody who stuck through with me for the, like, hour-plus missions, including the 90-minute battle to escape from Tarsonis. Well, I thank you for sticking with me, and I hope you come with me for the LP of the Zerg story mode. Because remember, it's only when the LP joins as one with his subscribers, the gentle viewers, it's only when you follow me, only when you join with me, that we can truly advance and we can truly conquer. I will see StarCraft correctly LP'd and fully LP'd, or I will see it burned before me. So come, folks, to my channel, to my little section of the internet. Come and watch videos as you stand before one throne, and from that throne, I will watch over you.